connection with me, Taj B, your international matchmaker and relationship consultant. So let's get right into it. Today we are talking about when times get hard. Hard times, individually and as part of our relationship. What is it that we should do, right? What do we do when times get hard? And you know, it was looking all springy and summery lately, right? So all those who are in Toronto, we were feeling nice until that rainstorm just seemed to be threatening our weekend, right? So hopefully we can do some prayers and keep that at bay. So let's get right to the point. We're talking about when times get hard. And let's just start it off by this. Each and every one of us, we're alive here today so that we can watch the show to get advice and tips on how to deal with our hard times. So the fact that we're alive to hear this on this lovely Friday, let's just all give thanks and feel blessed and feel happy about that, right? So times are hard. It seems like the first quarter of the year has been threatening to like ruin each and every one of us, eh? Like as everywhere I go, all the information I hear, the advice I give out, it seems that most of us are having a very hard time, right? And some of you are like, oh, not me, all is well in my camp. Well, good for you. But here's the thing about life. You know, it's a very funny roller coaster. Sometimes up, sometimes down, right? So be mindful. And we're going to be talking about in terms of your relationship when times are hard and individually when times get hard. What it is that we can do, how we can deal with them, how we can best, you know what I mean? Like, what are the ammunition we need to handle the hard times? Because here's the thing. Sometimes times get hard and we just get so stressed out, so frustrated. And because we're so upset about the hard time, we are unable to actually do anything at all about it. And your relationship hard times plays in with your individual hard times. Because if we're individually are doing well, our relationship can't possibly be doing well because it takes the both of us. And if one of us is down, then our relationship is suffering, right? Because we are in this together. I'm always saying this because it's most important. It's something that we definitely need to know, need to hear, and more importantly, need to practice. So based on what I've heard from you, my viewers, from my clientele, what I see out there, and what I know as an expert in the relationship field and in the lifestyle field, because I'm here for your life advice, right? From what I know, these are the types of hard times we could be seeing potentially. And you guys, if you're here watching and you're having a hard time right now, let us know. Type it in, put it in your comments, put it in our comment section, what hard time you're going through right now, and we will read it out and we will try our best. I will give a little bit of advice on it. So if I don't cover some of the hard times that you yourself personally are seeing, get at me and let me help you out, okay? So let's start. We have finances. These finances, you know, like, it's not a laughing matter. It's, you know, I'm laughing from stress, not because it's funny. Because the finances will stress us out, right, guys? And what do we do when our finances are stressing us? There's sometimes nothing we can actually do about it. Like, there's literally nothing you can do. Like, your bill is due today, you don't get paid till next Friday, and you have no way of coming up with the money in between. You know, you're not going to go juke somebody for the money, so what's going to happen now, right? And here's my advice. When there's nothing you can do about your finances, first of all, be sure that there is nothing you can do about the finances. Because sometimes your finances just require a little bit of thinking outside of the box, right? And maybe individually you're having a hard time with your money. Like, man, I want to take my girl out, but I don't have the money. I don't want to be looking like a bum, but I do love her. It's just payday is stretching out, you know? There are free things you can do about your city. And anywhere you live in the world, there are free things you can do. Okay? So don't be like, yeah, right, Taj. Which woman wants the free dates? All of us do. Because here's what we want. We want your time and your attention and your devotion above your finances. Okay? So if you can give us these things, but you're lacking in the finance, we can work with that. Most people can work with that. So give us the opportunity. free things you can do. You can go for a picnic. You can go watch a show, because there are a lot of free shows in and around the world, different cities in the world. You can do a little class, like, you know, a free tutorial class. You can go visit friends and family, you know, carry something that you already have at home in the fridge to go visit. So there are a lot of things you can do if it's just individual, okay? Another thing in regards to your finances, each and every one of us should be tapping into our full potential. We each must live up to our full potential, whatever that may mean for you. So if you have a talent for making cakes, make the damn cakes and sell them and try your best to start up a business or something. You know, if work isn't cutting it, if you, like, even maybe like me, you, like for me, my gift from God is I was born into the role of counselor. This is just what I feel my gift is, right? My gift of knowledge, my gift of advice, and my gift of understanding. So I have to look towards monetizing that and making that work for me. And that is available for each and every single one of you guys. You can make your talents pay you, monetize your talent. And how do you start that? Do some research. What are you good at? How can you get paid for what are you good at? Okay, so before we cry about our finances, we want to make sure that we truly have tried every method. Another method that I find is helpful for your finances is trying your best to live below your means. So don't live within your means. For example, I can afford this $50 luxury item. I can afford it just fine. But I'm not going to buy it because I'm going to live below my means. So I'm going to get something that's similar to this item, but it's $20 or $30 or so on and so forth. You understand? You get my drift? So maybe you would normally go out every Saturday, every weekend, because you can afford to go out every weekend. But now that you're living below your means, we're going to stay in now most weekends. We're going to entertain friends at our home instead of going out to spend money. Okay, so there are a lot of different things you can do to manage your finances better. And there's no reason today's a great day for us to start doing that, okay? Another thing is try to use cash. I know we are in a digital world. Give me a second here. We are in a digital world, but that doesn't mean that we can't go back to the basics. See, something happens when you have cash on you. You sort of just spend what you can afford to spend, what you have on you to spend right now, okay? So you put like a jar for your food every week. You start off with a budget. This is for food. This is for entertainment. This is for my bill. This is for that, whatever, whatever, okay? And then you leave the money in your little boxes, and that's all the money you're going to use, and you leave it in cash. So when the cash runs out, then you're just running out too as well, regardless of what you know you have in your bank account. So that is another good way to live below your means if you're struggling financially. And a lot of us don't know this, depending on where you live. Like, I lived in the Caribbean for a while, and I was so surprised when I would go online and find out all the different types of services that government programs have in place for the citizens of the country. Because you don't think about that. I know, like, I myself, I'm just giving you from my own experience, I assume that those types of services were like maybe North American things. But no, most places all over the world, and I have done my research over this past week, and, you know, my viewers are from all over. Shout out Africa, shout out Australia, shout out India, you know, shout out the Caribbean and North America. So I've done the due diligence and looked up what programs we have in most of the countries that follow us, and most of them have something for if your finances are not up to date. So make use of the programs and resources that your country government has put in place to help you out, right? Like, I mean, if you can get something from them, guys, trust me, get what you can when you can, right? Because it's not often that you're going to get something back from the powers that be. You understand? So do some research. Go on the computer tonight and type in government programs for underfinanced or underprivileged, or maybe you're looking for money to start a business, or you want somebody to help you write a grant or anything like that. So definitely just give it a try, because what do you have to lose? You're either going to get nothing or you're going to get something. And if you get nothing, you have nothing anyway, so you've lost nothing. And if you got something, then cha-ching, here you go, right? You can start on something new with your life, okay, guys? So that is in your finances. Work can also be giving us a hard time as well, because the thing is, it's work, but everybody there is acting like it's high school. What is this, right? Like the workplace politics, isn't that just enough to make you feel like you don't need to make a single dollar ever again? It does, it's stressful. How do you deal with the work problems? First of all, don't allow anybody to gossip about you, period, point blank, done. You hear that somebody says that they said, oh, so-and-so said this about you. As soon as they say it, no matter who the person is, go to so-and-so. Did you say this about me or not? This is what I'm hearing. What's going on, okay? Another thing that we have to understand is we are beings, spiritual beings in this world. Nobody sent you here without a purpose. Each and every one of us has a purpose here on this earth, okay? And that purpose does not include... Listen up to me, guys. Pick up your ears. That purpose does not include being somebody's slave. Never. Okay? So there are times when our bosses are taking advantage of us. And we have to be able to recognize those times, stand up for ourselves, and say, hey, you can't treat me like this because I am a human being. I'm an employee of your institution. What is this? Okay? And some of you are like, yeah, right, Taj, and then get fired. Then we won't have a paycheck, and then we're going to be in worse financial situation, you know, than we were originally. I understand that. Trust me, I do. I know you guys see me. My hair is like, I know a lot of hair, right? Shout out to my hairdresser and my stylist, right? So anyways, guys, so what I'm trying to say is we need to talk to our superiors at work and let them know that we are not slaves and we're not your children. We don't expect to be treated certain ways, spoken to in certain ways, and you have to stand up for yourself at work. Because if you're not willing to stand up for yourself, who is supposed to stand up for you? Right? Like, so this is just life, guys. Another thing is, remember that you're there with a purpose. You're gone to work to make money, to take care of yourself or your family. So all of the background social stuff that's happening there is not your problem. You can't be that bothered about it because you can't bring yourself to the level of these other people at your workplace. You understand what I'm trying to say? Like, you need to be a step above them. And in order to do that, you need to avoid their drama, avoid all the nonsense that they have going on. So if you're going to have to be the outcast and the outsider at work because you're not talking to anybody, then so be it, all right? Because that's just the only way to deal with this. Then another thing is, look for a new job. It's not the only job out there. I never leave one job without finding another one, okay? So in the meantime, just look for something else. Maybe you will find a better environment where you fit in better, work that's less stressful, who knows? But you won't know until you try, until you do something different. And the way to do it is to make one step. You know, start putting out your resumes other places. And another way to deal with work stress is to open a business of your own as well, right? Start looking about how can I be my own boss so I can have less of the stress of work. Another thing is sometimes it's not even the people at work that's a stress, but just the act of having to wake up to go to work or having to leave our children behind so that we can be at work. And here's my message to you. If you're having trouble being at work, like just getting there in the first place, it's going to sound pretty simple, but try to beat your fatigue with lemon and hot water first thing before you leave to go to work. It is actually like a life hack for beating fatigue. Yeah, so you guys, Taj, the gift that keeps on giving. So, you know, that's a little tip for you guys. Try lemon water, hot water. You will find that you're a little less tired as the days go out. Try to have some snacks to keep your blood sugar up while you're at work or you're on your way to work. Make sure you eat so your belly is full, because what we sometimes don't understand is we're getting feelings and they're like upset feelings, And we think that it's something else. Like, it's just the fact that we're at work. We're just like, oh my goodness. Every time I come to work, as soon as I get to work, I'm getting sick. But sometimes it has to do with the fact that you actually haven't eaten and you're not feeling well because of that. So try to eat a meal before you go to work, and that will limit the feeling sick feelings as the day goes on, okay? And try to find the fun in what you do, because if you don't like what you do, then, you know, if you don't like what you do, it's because you have chosen the wrong profession, okay? Like, we each be seeking to do what we love. And I know a lot of us from certain generations, we didn't have that choice and we didn't have that chance. And I understand that. I get that. So when you are working a job against your will, you just have to take some deep breaths, man. You got to stay above the drama. You got to stay up above all the nonsense that would be going on. So that's work. Then we have also, you can be going through infertility individually and as a couple. And that's a hard time, hard time, because nothing is worse than wanting a child and not being able to have a child. And then now it's spring. So every couple out there, an individual out there who is trying to conceive or has ever been trying to conceive, you know what spring means, right? Spring means everybody else is pregnant but you. So it's hard, and it's really hard to deal with. But here's what you can do. Make sure that you have done your research into your own infertility, looking up things, trying natural stuff at first, going to go see a specialist, because nothing is going to happen while you sit down there just fiddling your thumbs, right? Evidently, you've come to the point where there is an issue here. It's not working out as we planned or as it should or as we see it's supposed to. Now is the time to seek professional help, right? You go out and see, what can we do about this? You don't have to go to a regular Western doctor. You can go to a medicine person, like a herbalist, herb specialist. There are a lot of things. Sometimes it's just some yoga, different yoga practices you can try. So all you moms out there trying, or would-be moms trying, go look up like yoga for infertility that can help you, help align your body and align your mind so you can feel a little bit better about yourself as you're going through the process. And as you're going, as you're a couple going through this, support. Like, I can't say that enough. You need to be supporting each other. You have to know how she feels and how he feels. And then also, if you've already been to the doctor and somebody out of the two of you has been pinpointed as the issue, that person needs a lot of support here, right? Like, they need to be made to feel that the partner understands, the partner feels for them. Like, put yourself in their shoes. Oh my goodness, I can't imagine if this was me. Honey, you and I are going to work through this together, right? That's another way. Another thing is, sometimes even being around other children, other babies, can help you. A, with your infertility, yes. Like, I don't know if it's like the baby sprinkled baby dust on you or something like that, but yes, with getting the baby. And also, just in feeling better about yourself. Like, maybe you get to do some mothering or some fathering with some other children, and you kind of help you feel a little bit more fulfilled as an individual, even though you have not had a child of your own as of yet. And another thing is prayer, right? Like, prayer is there for a reason. If you are somebody who believes in a higher power, then try that. Try praying about your infertility and praying for a clear mind so you can feel better. And go out, guys. Like, don't just stay home feeling bad, having your time sex and chick and all that ovulation stuff. So just put that all away for a little bit and just focus on each other. And I will give you some advice that I heard from my own mom, was that sometimes what you want will happen when you least expect it. So try to not put your mind on it. And I found that to be very helpful advice. Shut up, Mom. So, you know, like, just try to take your mind off of it. Don't even think about the fact that we're trying to conceive. Don't think about the fact that we don't have one yet. Just think about anything else but that. And move on with your life as if you're not trying to conceive. And I find you will see, you will get a surprise somewhere along the road. So just take it easy, guys, when it comes to infertility, because A lot of it sometimes is something we can do stuff about, and a lot of it we cannot. So we need to recognize the difference between those two different types of things as it relates to infertility and take it from there, okay? And I hope you guys, if you are having any hard time, that you are typing it in. And if you're watching us, I hope you hit that like button and that subscribe button so you can always get our episodes after they air, okay? And maybe it might be you're going through grief, like you have lost someone, yourself out there. And I just want to give my condolences to each and every one of you who is going through grief right now, who's lost someone that you love and has to live on this earth without somebody that is dear to you. My heart goes out to you. And if you are in need of any grief counseling and you would like to speak about it, then you can hit me up, and you can do that by going on the website at www.theloveconnection.ca. And I will use my own experience with grief and my expertise to try to help you out to the best of my ability. So if you're going through grief, try to do stuff that reminds you of the person. And then if you find that's too hard, then you try to avoid stuff that reminds you of the person, okay? You can make a scrapbook for them. You can talk about them to the people who can handle being spoken to about them. But the thing is, take your time to go through the grief sequences. Right? Like, let your grief happen as it wants to happen. Don't force yourself to be like, I should be over this by now, or I shouldn't be worried about this by now, or I shouldn't be thinking about this by now, or anything along those lines. You understand? Like, just go with the flow. How you're feeling today, work with that. How you're feeling tomorrow, work with that. And don't ever feel like you have to apologize to anyone because of how you feel. It's your grief, and you can handle it as you see fit. And nobody should come in the way of that, okay? If you as a couple are dealing with grief, perhaps you have lost a child yourself as a couple, or you as a couple have lost someone who is very dear to you. All you can do in this time is lean on each other. You must be each other's strongest support during such a hard time. You must never be able to find better support with somebody who is outside of your relationship than with the person you have experienced this grief with, okay? And that is a lot, because we deal with things differently because we are individuals. So how one person may see something is not the way another person will. So maybe you're a talking, and the other person isn't into that. Like my husband and I, we have different communication styles. So we have to learn to work around that when we're going through an issue, right? Where I want to talk, he just, maybe I don't really want to talk about it. So he has to give and sometimes talk, and I have to give and sometimes listen and not talk so much. So it's the same for you guys, right? Maybe your grief process is a lot of crying, and your partner's grief process is a lot of being silent on the situation and the topic. So whatever it is, definitely work with each other, and don't make anybody feel bad because of how they're grieving, how their grief process is working, or what they are going through, okay? And we have your health, like just your health. Maybe you're having a hard time now, guys, because of your health. You're not in the best of health. And everybody out there who is in good health, like, you need to be very, very extremely grateful. Because there is nothing in this world that you can have that is more important and more priceless than your health. And once you have your health and your life, you have everything, guys. The world is an endless amount of possibilities for you, because you actually have the ability to accomplish the things that you want done, okay? So if you're not in the best of health, first of all, don't continue doing what you've always been doing. So perhaps you have, you know, like a very serious disease that you're living with, or a condition. Anytime is a great time to start doing some research and look into alternative ways to deal with this problem that you're having, right? Like, so you've been taking the same pills, you've been going to the same doctors. I'm not here. Don't go and tell your doctor that, oh, look here, doc, Taj told me that I need to stop seeing you and stop taking these meds. No, I did not. But what I am saying is this. It's time to try something new. There's no harm in that. And try something natural. because I believe that everything to help us is here on the earth, right? And our, like, the natural food that grows out of this earth is so beneficial to our health and our bodies, and we just don't want to make use of it. Like, I don't know how many times we're going to find out that the basic ingredients behind most medication are plant-based, are natural-based. So why would they make medicines out of plants if the plants were not good for us, huh? Right? So keep that in mind and try alternative paths to medicine. Maybe you need to go see a chiropractor, get your spine aligned. And because I was just watching, I was doing some work the other day. You know when you're watching something, a commercial comes on for a long time? And it was a commercial for actually a Toronto chiropractic center. And I was very interested because they were going on as to how aligning your spine can actually help with a multitude of other health conditions and diseases. I was like, is that so? Say more, you know? And then I went to go do some research because I'm like, if I'm going to come and talk about this on Friday, let me know what I'm talking about, right? And in doing my research, I found that, yeah, the Toronto Chiropractic Center knows what they're talking about. Apparently, getting your spine aligned will help you with a lot of other issues like asthma, respiratory issues, stomach issues, bowel issues. So, you know, maybe give that a try if you haven't as of yet. Another thing, don't keep your health concerns a secret. No way, Jose. Especially if you have anybody, and I mean anybody in your life that cares about you, let them know. Let them know what you're going through. Let them know what's happening in your life. Let them know what stage you're at in terms of your health. And you never know. Maybe they can be the support that you always wanted, okay? And in terms of a relationship, nothing is worse than when your partner is sick. And, you know, like, who wants that? Who wants their woman to be sick? And you can't do anything about it. It makes us as the healthy partner feel so weak and little and useless and hopeless, right? So here's what you do. You do your research about your partner's health condition. You come to your partner, beeps. I found out that if you eat 2 bananas a day, that will help your cornea look better, you know, or whatever. And then you start bringing the bananas. And then you want to show your partner that we are united in this. You may be the one with the health concern and the condition, but we are in this together, right? And if you're trying to get your health together, like you're down and you're having a hard time because you have some weight to lose, your doctor gave you that bad letter that if you don't lose X amount of pounds by this date, a heart attack for you for sure, and you're just down about that, don't worry, because that's something that's within your control to do something about. And that's what we're looking for. We're looking for problems that we can do something about. That's when we know, oh, thank goodness, this is a good problem, right? Like, because we can work towards making it better, and we can never want anything more than that. All right. So if you are in that situation, the best thing to do about that is get on the rest of your life. Today is a great day to start the rest of your life. That is another famous Taj quote that I say all the time because it's very true. So you plan to work out today. You plan to start drinking more water, drink more water today. You plan to start eating healthier, go to the supermarket and buy some vegetables today. Why not? What's stopping you? And if it is the finances, I bet you would go and buy some McDonald's though, right? So then next we've got the children, the kids, right? Like these babies will stress us to the point of madness, won't they? And then maybe, you know, your kid isn't a bad kid. They're just a good kid, but they're going through hard times. And you're hurt because you don't want that for your child. You don't want to see your child in pain. You don't want to see them suffering. You don't want to see them hurt. And the best you can do in that situation, parents, is just be supportive. Don't be crying more than the child. You know what I mean? And like help them to better understand the situation that they're in, because you should better understand because you are the parent here. You have decades on them, hopefully, right? So you are able to say, listen, young man, I know what this is like. I've been there before, or I have not been there before, but as an adult, like a bigger person to you, this is what I understand you should do about it. So talk to your children regardless of what age and stage they are at. Another thing, if they're like younger ones, but not the baby ones, like, you know, like teenagers and the preteens, right, guys? Like teenagers, right? Oh my goodness. So if you're going through the dreaded teenager stage, here's what you do. First of all, make boundaries very clear and don't skirt around the boundaries. Like, you need to be home at this time, you need to do this at that time, this, that, and the other. Otherwise, bad things will happen. And the bad things are, I will take everything that you love away, or whatsoever you know, because you know your kid, whatever you know works best for them, then you do that and use it against them in order to get them to comply. Because I am not part of this, let children do as they please until they're ready to come around to what you're trying to tell them. No, for what? No. You put your foot down, you lay the ground down, because you are the parent here. If God wanted your child to rule you, then your child would have birthed you, right? And that is not the way that it worked. That's not the sequence of events that happened. It was you, then your child. So you are an authority here, and there's nothing wrong with using your authority, because this is what will save your children and this future generation from going where we know they're going, in a handbasket. Like, we need to be assertive as parents about how we're raising our kids, what we need, what we want from them, and that they should comply when we talk. This is not like abuse or anything like that, guys. Who is the adult here? And I mean, a child is okay to have their own opinion and stuff, but, you know, and talking about the opinion, here's another thing. While, so the parents of the little tiny ones, I know a lot of us seem to think, like, when the children are so small and they're being rude, it's so cute. Like, oh my goodness, they're not listening when I'm talking. Isn't that so cute? Or they're so rude. Nothing. It's not funny. And you will suffer for it later on. So cut that out while you can, while they're young. Never encourage your child to disrespect you, be rude to you, laugh at you, or mock you, and then you laugh with them as if it's a joke. It's not a joke. Because then as they get older, that's the kind of respect that they will continue to have for you. Because that's what you taught them is okay. So get on that while you can. Because let me tell you something, there's actually a stage in your child's life where you can't do anything about that. So while you can, work on it. Today is a great day to start the rest of your life. Another thing is, sometimes you have to ignore them, guys. Not the baby ones. We can never ignore those. But at a certain stage, like 6+, yeah, sometimes you need to ignore them for your own health, the sake of your own life, the sake of your relationship. Because what I always advise couples is this. Listen, you had these children, or we, all of us parents I'm talking to, we had these children for two reasons, out of love or out of lust. Done. That's it. Point blank, period. We loved the person we were with, and we wanted to bring a child in the world with them. Or we have so much love to give, we want to share that with another being and create that being out of love. Or it was lust, and lust was so good that then a baby came. Right? So either way, it was not because we hoped that one day they would be a little terrorist, terrorize our life, mash us down, so that when people see us in public, they're like, oh my goodness, what happened to you? Oh, it's my kids, it's my kids, it's my kids. Like, come on, no. That was not the whole point of being a parent. So sometimes you've got to ignore them. Like, you tell them 100 times, no running with the socks in the house. Stop running. And they're running, running, running. They won't stop. And then finally they run and slid into the wall. Don't even move. Depending on their age, don't even look up. Because, come on, who's supposed to drop dead over stress over these kids, guys? Not me and not you, my followers and listeners. So listen to Taj. Sometimes you just got to let them be. And sometimes another thing, what you have to understand is, we make these children, but we don't make their personalities. We don't make their soul. We don't control who they're going to be and what they're going to become. So your kid is bad as hell, or they grew up to be so useless. It's like, why did I go through all this to raise you and you're so garbage today, right? It's just like, you just got to let that go, because this is not you. This is not an onus on you. It's not a sign that you were a bad parent. Each individual makes their own choice because that's the main gift that we were given from our creator. And that's the gift of free will. So you have free will and so does your children. So as they grow, they're making a decision regardless of what you're teaching them. They're making a decision as to what they want to do. And another note for parents is this. A lot of us are like, I didn't train you that way. I didn't teach you to do this. But here's the thing. Children don't always listen to what we say, but they're always watching what we do. Okay? So they always watch what we do. So therefore, they will emulate things, your actions. So be careful of the actions that you show your children. Another, we have, if you're trying to get ahead and you just can't. Like you're trying and you're trying this, you're trying a new business, you're trying a new job, you're trying to do better, you're trying to lose the weight, you're trying to get healthy, you're trying to gain the weight. Like, you know, because there's different spectrums and you're trying, but nothing is happening. So it's a hard time you're going through. Listen, just take a moment, breathe, revisit your plan, make sure you're doing all that you can. And the way that you do that is research, research, research. So I want to open a restaurant. Have I really done all I was supposed to? Have I really looked into all the licensing and requirement that I need? You know, do I have the right people on my team? These are the things you have to look into. And never just, because listen, a man can fail many times, okay? But you're not a failure until you blame someone else, right? So you have to take ownership of what you are willing to do for your own life and your own future. So things are getting hard. If you know that you're doing all that you can, just continue doing all that you can. And trust me, eventually it will work out, guys. Body image, you're having a hard time because you don't like the way that you look. You don't feel that your partner likes the way that you look. That's something that you can do something about. And if it's not, like if it's actually just your features, like you're like, my head is just too big. We can't shave down our heads. So you're just gonna have to learn to love yourself. And if the person that you're with doesn't love you for you, that's not your soulmate, get rid of them and contact me at www.theloveconnection.ca and let me find you someone who will love you big head and all. And your family can be giving you a hard time as well, right? Because sometimes these families, it's like, where did you come from with all the stress? And you only have one family until you make a family of your own. And then if the family that you made is stressing you out, well, you made that. You chose this family, right? What do you want now? But just love your people. Be glad that you even have people to stress you out. If they're doing very outrageous stuff, get away from them. Nothing says that we need to be hitched up underneath our family and taking all the abuse that they have to give us. This is a big, wide world. You're free to go as far as you want. Actually, the other day, I was reading some quotes, and they had a Sicilian quote that was like, if you want a happy life, move far away from your family. And I couldn't stop laughing. I don't feel that way. You know what I mean about my family? But I understand what that quote means. Sometimes, with all their nya, 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 nya in your head, and all their, oh, are you doing it like that? You shouldn't do it like that. You should do it like this. You should do it, nya, 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 nya. You know, it's too much. You know, it's going to drive you totally insane. So it is best to step away from that. Or you just take everything they say with a grain of salt. You don't let people's words bother you too much and make boundaries. So maybe you say to them, listen, me and my man, we need this amount of time alone to ourselves. And this quarter is to ourselves. There's nothing wrong with that. You're a couple. There's two of you in the relationship. Yes, you married a person's family too, but come on. We need our space, right? Another, then in a relationship, so those are the different types of hard times we can do it. Even your mental health, like maybe you're having a hard time with your mental health. And if you're here in Toronto and you're having a hard time with your mental health, definitely contact the good folks at CAMH because that's what they're there for, right? To help each and every one of us get through the hard times that we are having. So here, if you're having a hard time and it's your mental health, stop, breathe, and step aside because nothing is worth your mental health. You need to get to a space where you can handle whatever situation it is. And then sometimes you need to just think, what is going on? Like, why am I this upset? should I really be this upset, or am I over-exaggerating? Because sometimes we over-exaggerate our own problems to ourselves. And then you listen to the old age saying that if everyone was to throw their problems in a basket, you would pick yours up and run. It is true, guys. Like, trust me, I'm here to tell you, in this wide world, we are all suffering. And your suffering is no more than the next human being suffering. I suffer no more than you. You suffer no more than me. And if we can just come to understand that, we would have a better life. We would have a better society. We would have a better world. Because I, like, you know, love one another. It's as simple and as hard as that. That's it. Okay, guys? And then in your hardness in terms of your relationship, you're going through a hard time with your spouse. First of all, if you have the main thing, that's love and acceptance in your relationship, then that's good. You love them, they clearly seem to love you, good. So the time that you're going through isn't really that hard. So it's like, put a smile on your face and feel like, oh my gosh, I'm so glad Taj said that, because it's true, at least we love each other. So whatever problem we're going through, that can be worked on, right? Another thing is, you need to give your partner time to process and grow. So maybe you're having a hard time right now because of certain activities that your partner partakes in and you wish that they would stop. Like maybe you feel like it's so annoying that they want to play NBA 2K8 like all evening long when they come home from work with their friends, and then evening time, then they're ready for you. That's so stupid, you feel, right? But your man may not be doing that forever. Like, there is a point where he will outgrow that. And if you're willing to wait on that point, then good for you, okay? And if your woman, she's just being moody, you're having a hard time because nothing you do seems to work, nothing you do seems to please her, talk to her about that. Honey, tell her the truth. Honey, I feel as if nothing I'm doing pleases you. Like, I'm always talking about this, assertive conversation, because listen, are you guys listening? Your partner is not, I repeat, not a mind reader. Never will they be. So they have no way of knowing what's going on in your mind if you don't share that with them. Tell them how you're feeling, guys. Tell them what's going on with you, okay? And then another thing, you're having a hard time. Sometimes you guys just need like a break. You need to miss each other a little bit. Like, you know, one of you go stay by your mom's, one of you go stay with a friend for 2 days, and then come back, and you find absence does make the heart grow fonder, okay? Another thing, you're having a hard time as a couple, you want to work on that together as a unit. Like a couple of mine, I'll segue to a story time. A couple clients of mine, they had a business together, and their business was failing. But, and this is a hard time they're going through because they spent a lot of time building that business up. Now, the man, he was not good with numbers. He's not good at crunching numbers. He's not a finance person. But the woman, she was. So as her business is failing, she's working very hard on the finance aspect of it, paper punching, trying to figure it out, and trying to work it out so that they can be in a better position, right? And he now wasn't doing much because he felt like there was nothing I could do. This is not within my realm. And how they ended up coming to me was she was feeling like, on top of the hard time that we're having in business, we're having a hard time in our relationship as well because I feel unsupported by my partner. So when I spoke to him about not supporting her, he was shocked because he's like, I thought we were in this hard time together. Like, we are always talking and stressing about how we feel together. Oh my gosh, Taj. I'm like, yeah, but you're not, because you're just on the sidelines cheering her on and not doing nothing. So you need to start doing some research. You need to start seeing how you can get some more clientele for you guys' business. You need to be at least showing her by action that I'm working towards making this better. You just sitting down there cheering her on, oh, good job, babe. Nice, babe. You're doing well, babe. We can't eat those things. We can't take those things to the bank. We need concrete, proper help, okay? And in order, so get your hands dirty and get to it. So that is a notion, guys. Help out in every aspect that you can in your relationship, because there's two of you. Not one person's raising the kids. Not one person's doing the housework. Not one person doing this, one person that. One person doing all the money. One person arranging all the banking. No, we are doing this together. And even if one thing is somebody's strength and something is somebody else's strength, we can still work on it as a team, okay? So that is that, guys, in all my topics for different ways that things can get hard. So what I'm going to do is give you methods of de-stressing. I'm just going to run through a couple of them quickly. And if you guys have some of your own, put them in on the comments, okay? So what can you do to de-stress? Ready? We have workout. We have go out. We have meditation. You can go out to do something free if there's no finances, like I said already. Read. You can go see an old friend. You can volunteer your time, because volunteering really helps us to feel better about ourselves. And if we volunteer with people who are less fortunate than us, it kind of helps us to feel more blessed about the situation that we're in, okay? Watch motivational videos. I find that helps me, like, you know, somewhat just like Tony Robbins speaking in the background and all these nice images. I like that. That seems to help me out, so maybe it'll help you guys out too. Build something with your hands. Learn a new skill, take a walk, listen to some music, start a new project, do arts and craft and coloring. I took up adult coloring the other day. It was a lot of fun, guys. So I suggest that to each and every one of you. And, you know, ignore everything, too. Sometimes you just need to ignore everything. That's something you can do. But don't ignore, like, the big things, such as Mother's Day, which is coming up very soon, next Sunday. And your girl, Taj B, is going to be on Mother's Day, the launch of the Taj B show. So remember, guys, I told you guys about that, that they gave me another show. And I will be doing all, you know, everything. I'll be covering each and everything that there is out there in the world. So if there's something you want me to cover on the Taj B show, let me know, okay? Yeah, let me know what's going on. And then if there's, you know, you yourself would like to be a guest on the Taj B show, then definitely hit me up and I will get back to you. So if you have your own methods on de-stressing, then you definitely, sorry guys, little hook, my shoe. If you have your own method of de-stressing, then, oh, you know what that means. When you hear the bell, guys, it is time for the Match of the Week. And what is the Match of the Week? So every week, I will be featuring a potential husband or a potential wife. And if they sound like your soulmate, then you hit me up on any of the social media pages, Twitter, that's Love Connect TV, Instagram, The Love Connection Show, or on the website itself, and that's www.theloveconnection.ca. So here we go. Let me ask the gallery, should we start with men or shall we start with women? Men! Okay, men, let's go. Ladies, pick up your ears because this may be your king. Let's go. He is a 52-year-old Jamaican based in New York. He has been there for 25 years and he has 4 adult children. He is divorced for the past 12 years and owns 2 barbershops plus a takeout spot. He enjoys his cultural stuff and he's looking for a woman who is into the same. So if you like all things Jamaican, this is your man. He is giving, kind, and he's looking for heart, not looks. So he doesn't care really what you look like. He just wants to know you've got a good something underneath the ribcage. He's tall, he's dark, he's bearded, and handsome. So if he sounds like your future husband, then hit me up and I will suss you out. Here we have the females, guys. So men, listen up, listen up. And we are only looking for the gentlemen here. So non-gentlemen, close your ears. So we have a female and she is 68 years old. She's a 68-year-old Canadian woman looking for someone to spend the rest of her life with. She enjoys life, travel, outdoors, golf, television, and entertaining. And she is looking for her ideal traditional gentleman. She knows how to, who knows how to treat a lady and is in her age range. She is Caucasian and looking for the same. So if you're out there and it sounds like you would love this lady for yourself, then hit me up and we shall go through. Next, we have our Dear Taj segment, guys. And what is a Dear Taj segment? You've got an issue, any issue, you send it in to me and I will do my best to answer the question. If you want me to answer the question live on air, then you write answer on air when you send the question in. Okay, guys? So here we go. Dear Taj, My family does not know I'm pregnant. They don't like my man. They said I shouldn't be with him. I'm already 5 months pregnant. I live at home and can't leave yet and don't want to do that. I'm just scared of how they're going to act and what they're going to and say that they were right and that I'm ruining my life. I'm 25 and so is my boyfriend. Just they don't support us. Help. Pregnant and running out of time. Okay, so thank you, Pregnant and Running Out of Time, for sending that message to me, dear Taj. Well, first of all, last time I checked, and that was 5 minutes ago, bellies grow out. They don't go in. So the pregnancy, whether you're ready to tell or not, sometime the belly will be ready to tell for you, Pregnant and Running Out of Time. So you need to tell them right away. And then the next thing is, you know, it sounds like maybe your people might be right. Because if you're 25, you live at home, which there's nothing wrong with that, right? And then this other 25-year-old guy has impregnated you after the people said he was a bad guy. And then now he lets you go 5 months without going to your family. Maybe your family is onto something, right? And regardless if they were or they were not, you're already pregnant. So now you need to come and tell them this. And here's the thing that we all need to understand. When we have done something against what our family and friends had advised us to do, and we've already gone and done it, and now we have to come back and say that, it is your job to prove that you know what you're doing. Yeah, it's your job to prove that you're gonna be okay. It's your job to prove all the worries that we had about you are unfounded. And you're not doing that right now, Pregnant and Running Out of Time, because now you're 5 months. That means, are you getting stuff for the baby? Are you preparing for this child, this life that you're bringing into the world? Is the man looking about getting an apartment? Are you guys employed? How do you plan to support this child? Like, you can't move. Why? Right? So you need to go talk to your family and get their support. And you need to talk to your man and find out, why are you okay with me doing this? Because it's not an okay thing to do. So my advice to you, because you just want to know what to do, right? So you should go talk to them now, like right now. And you need to talk to your, and bring your man with you. But you guys have a plan. Like, don't just go stand up in front of the people like, we had sex and now we're pregnant. Like, no, go there with, you know, ammunition. He is in school. I am in school. We intend to have careers. We will be living here. This is how we will raise a child. This is what we will do. We need your help because we are not ready. And this is how we need your help. That's how you present it. So you're going to go present this like it's like a business plan or something to your family. And the main thing is you need to show them that this guy was a good choice to breed for because he is going to support you and this child. So he needs to, not you help him put that together. He needs to be able to have that as a man on his own and as a soon-be father. What is his intention? And come bring that intention to your family, okay? So Pregnant and Running Out of Time, I hope that helped. I hope that answered your question, okay? Now, guys, it is time for the misconnections. And you know it's misconnections when you hear Mr. Richie's voice on the air. Let me get the misconnections on.
Hello. Is it me you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes.
I love that. So what is a misconnection? Anywhere you are in the world, send it to me. Doesn't matter because it's an international show. If you see someone for a fleeting moment of your life and you don't get their contact information, but you love them and you feel like this person is meant to be mine, then you send me the information as to what happened, how it happened, and I will try my best to find that person for you. I mean, I've already found one. I mean, I could die happy now because I found one. Like, so that is, I don't know, has anyone else in the world ever found a misconnection? I don't know. I don't think so. So you guys play with me. I'm going to have that on all my flyers. One and only ever found misconnection person. So here we go. Misconnection, okay? This one comes out of St. Lucia. So shout out to the 758. Hello, guys. So St. Lucia, this happened at Irie Bar on Church Street. Oh, I love when you guys give me the actual location. So Irie Bar on Church Street in St. Lucia. Oh, contest time. So any of my viewers who know where this is, Irie Bar in St. Lucia on Church Street, I challenge you to send me a picture to any of our social media pages. You can find us on Facebook at The Love Connection TV and send us a photo. You can even upload it at the bottom of this video and send us a photo of what you bought there, like a drink, you hanging out, anything, and let us know I was at the Irie Bar in St. Lucia on Church Street. And then we will send you $20 Canadian so you can buy some more drinks at the bar. How nice. So let's get right into it. The misconnection. I was on the front stools having a drink. You were passing by with two girls. You had on a beach hat and jean shorts and pink purplish top. I called to you, you stopped and chatted. Said you guys was vibesin. Your friends called you and you rushed away. When I came around the corner, you wasn't there. I want to see you again. You're very beautiful. And from what you were saying, I think you would make a nice wife. Whoa, there we go. Madame in the jean shorts and the pinkish purplish top, who was going to the beach with your two girlfriends, and you passed and seen a brother. He doesn't describe himself. He said nothing on himself. But you seen a brother in St. Lucia on the stools, and you took a moment and you chatted with him, and then skirted off with your girlfriends to laugh. Okay, maybe not to laugh. Sorry to say that. But you skirted off with your girlfriends after. We're looking for you. And girlfriends, if you guys remember this incident, tell your girl that the guy that she stopped to talk to is in love with her and wants to talk to her. And the owners of the Irie Bar, or the patrons, or the people that work there, anybody, if you guys remember this incident and you happen to know that girl, please help me to find her. And also tell your customers to send me a picture if they wanted $20, all right? So that, guys, was the misconnection section. So now I am going to be doing the lover shout-outs. And what are the lover shout-outs? If you want to shout-out your lover, you want to let them know how special they are to you, then you hit me up and I will do that for you right here live on Friday. Right here, you can check us out at 7 p.m. on at The Love Connection TV on Facebook. And after we air live at 7 p.m. every Friday, you can then subscribe to our YouTube channel because all our episodes are there for you to see. Okay? So if you're on YouTube, hit that subscribe button. And if you're on Facebook, hit that like. Okay, so lover shout out. This one, both are from the website. This one comes from Ben Talamo. Ben Talamo, he wants to let Josepha know that she will be the mother of his future children. He will never have another girlfriend, and he will wait until you return. So wherever you are, Jafella, he is waiting, and he is waiting patiently until you come back. So now the second one, here we go. This also came in on our website, and it's from a woman named Lisa M. Lisa M says, my man is the best man that there ever was. My man Jodis, he does everything for me. He cook, he clean, he wash the children them. I couldn't ask for a better man. He treat my family so good. God bless the day that I meet this man. Taj, make sure you tell him how much I love him and that he's so special. I hope I did a good job. You hear that? You are so special to your woman, Lisa M. So thank you guys so much for that. I truly enjoyed this entire hour. I hope you guys did too. I love coming here each and every Friday and glowing up on the stage and giving you guys the tips and advice and the ammunition that you need to make your relationship work. And if you're not in a relationship, at least you're learning ahead of time. And if you're not, then you have the opportunity to get in one because I am Madame Matchmaker, right? So before I go, let me give you Taj's thought of the day. You can't handle it. You just can't. It's not worth your mental health. step aside, take a break, take a breath, and revisit it when you can. That's it for today, guys. And as always, I'm not going to let you guys just go just so. I am going to be playing one of my favorite tracks. And like I told you guys, I have an eclectic taste in music. So this one is from my boy, Toby Keith. You guys can go check out the video after. And it is called, I Ain't As Good As I Once Was. I love me some country.
She said, hello, my name is Bobby and Joe. Ain't my twin sister Betty Lou. And we're both being a kind of
wild. So nice, right? By KRFMS.
The only cowboy in this place. And if you're up for a
go check out my stylist, guys. You want to look this good? At Mestigo Boutique. Oh, yeah.
As good as I once was. I got a few years on the run now. But there was a time back in my prime